We've got a television show of our own. Making stuff that's been designed by you lot at home. Building your inventions the best that we can. Mostly our rubbish from the back of our van. We've even got a title that will grab your attention. All together now. In and out of this adventures.
Oh dear. The old van doesn't sound too healthy, does it? For a minute there, I thought the van was going to explode or something. Unless that's part of a magic show, I think we're in trouble. It's not part of a magic show.
Hard enough.
Well, we're here now, we might as well go and surprise Molly.
Who? Who's Molly?
What do you mean, who? Molly. She wrote to us with this really good idea for a rainbow go-go. Yeah? You spoke to her mum. You found out what her favourite thing in the world ever is.
Oh, dee-dee.
Yeah, there you go. You got there in the end, didn't you? Come on, let's go and surprise her.
Oh, but then I got a lot of costumes.
Costumes? You're absolutely sure you heard right about this?
Oh, dee-dee-dee. I do a lot now.
I didn't look nice. I look like a total dinger.
No.
Oh.
Huh?
Look, Molly's dad's got a camper van like ours.
Oh, no. It's Westphalia 1972.
That's a Westphalia 1972.
Mm-hmm.
Since when were you a world expert on vans?
Hmm.
Oh, actually, maybe Molly could fix our van while we make her invention.
Ah, dee. Oh.
Surprise!
Hey!
Hi, Ed. Hi, Archer.
Hello.
Why are you dressed as goblins?
No, we're not goblins. We're elves. Ding, 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 ding.
Why are you dressed as elves?
Oh, they're going to do lots of deals.
Yeah, because you love elves. Happy Elf Day. Hurrah. Hurrah for our elfic friends. Ding, 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 ding.
No, I don't.
Yes, you do. Yeah, you got all the Elvis films.
All the Elvis albums.
And the Elvis albums.
Elvis. I love Elvis.
Can we come in?
OK, but you have to take your shoes off.
Oh, because of the carpet?
No, because you look stupid.
Carcass.
Oucho, don't be so rude shouting about cake like that. Have you got any cake?
I've got a bit of carrot cake.
Carrot cake? Carrot is not a flavour for a cake. Chocolate is a flavour for a cake. Yeah, or bananas. Mm. Carrot cake. Ugh. Oh, by the way, couldn't help noticing that you've got a van like ours outside.
No, ours is a Westphalia 1972.
Totally.
Yeah, whatever. Anyway, ours is broken. I was wondering whether you might be able to fix it.
Well, I can't, but my dad might be able to.
Oh, can you give him a shout?
Dad!
Yes, Molly?
Do you think you could help fix Ed and Archer's van?
Yeah, I'll have a look.
Oh, Grace.
Wow.
Cheers. Oh, and if you find any non-carrot-based cake on your travels, it wouldn't be the worst thing in the world. So, just pop that on your head there. This will suck out all the great ideas. Just tell us all about it.
I want to invent a weather machine so I can party with my friends. I want it to make fluffy white clouds and rainbows. It should also have a donut drawer and a disco ball to make sparkly lights. I'd also like it to play my favourite Elvis song so I can party with my friends.
That sounds great. What's your favourite Elvis song, Molly?
Blue Suede Shoes.
And when are your friends coming to party with the Rainbow Go-Go?
On Saturday.
Saturday? That's in 3 days.
Ed, I found out I was wrong. There's a banana stuck in the exhaust.
How many times have I told you it eats petrol?
$9!
Yes, it does!
$9.
It's gonna cost a fortune to sort all that out. We're totally broke. We wasted all our money on these stupid costumes.
Oh, yeah, man, this is gold now.
Yes, yes, it would be great to have some gold, wouldn't it? Unfortunately, we haven't got any.
Ebbe, basta, but I'm not a robot.
We are not gonna find any at the end of the rainbow. I keep telling you, it's a myth. He talks like a twaddle. But I think we're gonna have to do something normal, like earn it. How do we earn money again? Oh, that's right, yes, yes. By making inventions on the telly. So, let's make money! I mean, let's make Molly's Rainbow Go-Go! Ah, look at all this great stuff I found in the van!
Huh?
And best of all, donuts! Oh. For the Rainbow Go-Go. This is going to be a piece of cake.
Oh, peanut cacas!
Just an expression.
Yeah.
Ah,
Oucho. Did you eat the donuts?
Nos.
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 Did you eat the donuts?
D.
And I thought this was going to be a piece of cake.
Oh, peanut cacas!
No, it's just an expression.
Oh.
Right. Buy more donuts. Well, we've got a music player, though, this old stereo.
Oh, they have Dolly Parton sometimes.
No, Dolly Parton's not inside it, don't worry. No, she's not.
They are put out with this elf bomb.
You didn't shrink her with your special elf powers. That just happened in your mind, didn't it?
They.
Also, we've got these for clouds. Look at that. And with this, we can make the rain, you see?
Yeah.
It's going to be great. I'm just a bit worried about the rainbow maker and that other thing, the disco ball. Oh, I know. I'll ask the internet.
Ah.
I'll just give it a ring. I'm sure it's not busy. Oh, who's that? Hello? It's Ed here.
Oh, hi, Ed. Listen, I don't really take phone calls. Would you mind referring to one of my many excellent websites? I'm a bit tied up at the moment.
Yeah, you see, the thing is, we're in a bit of a hurry. We've got to make a disco ball for this thing called a rainbow a-go-go.
A disco ball. Right, I've got one here.
What colour is it?
It doesn't have a colour. It's sort of a shiny ball.
Shiny ball. Right. Well, what colour is it?
It's not got a colour. It's a disco ball.
Listen, it's all to do with light. Hang on.
I've got a page about it somewhere. Ah, yes, here it is. One of my better ones, too. You see, light, like from the sun or a bulb, may appear to be white, but it's actually made of lots of different colours. Red, yellow, orange, green...
Blue,
what?
Violet. Are you following me? Do you understand?
When light hits an object, some of the colours are absorbed by it and others bounce back off it into our eyes, which is why we see it as the colour. I mean, take, for example, something yellow. I don't know, say... Custard! Ah, no! Not custard! Oh, take a banana. Right, now, when light hits a banana, some of the colours are absorbed by it and others bounce back off it into our eyes, which is why we see the banana as yellow. Likewise, tomato sauce.
No, not tomato sauce! No, a tomato!
Now, when light hits a tomato, the light bounces off it and absorbs some of the colours, except for red, which bounce right back off it into our eyes, which is why we see the tomato as red.
Are you following me?
What?
Are you even listening to me? You phone me up, you interrupt my string experiment, and you don't even listen to my answer!
Hello?
Yeah, you've been very helpful.
Hello?
Goodbye! Oh, that internet is boring. It'll never catch on. I mean, basically, if we want to make a disco ball, we just need a big shiny ball.
I am the hot boss!
We've got a ball.
There, look!
Oh! All right, now, how do we make it shiny? What's shiny?
Our bandy.
Our van.
Dee.
Oh, yeah, we'll just paint it the same colour as our van. Piece of cake.
Pecagas.
It's just an expression. It's just an expression. Yeah. Right, let's get this stuff, make our weather machine. Are you excited?
Yeah.
This is my favourite part of the show, this. Seeing the look on their little faces.
Yeah.
Okay. Ta-da!
Wow!
You see, dreams really can come true. What are your first impressions?
It's rubbish.
What?
That's why.
No.
Well, that's a bit of card.
No, it's a rainbow. Oucho got that out of the sky. There's also this here, you see? That's your disco ball there.
Oh,
I know
wow.
It may not look much now. Yeah, but look at this.
Oh, it's lossily.
It's not doing anything.
It is. It's shiny. Look how shiny it is.
It's not shiny at all.
And what do you think of that? That's your clouds, you see?
It looks a lot like cotton wool.
It may look like cotton wool, but clouds look like cotton wool. See, we brought the weather inside.
Oh, dee.
It's still rubbish.
Actually, no, you know who's to blame for this fiasco? It's him. Because I had something very urgent to attend to, and I left it all up to him.
No,
he built it. I hate it as much as you. Kick it.
What?
Yes, it's rubbish. Don't you worry, though. We won't rest until this invention is perfect. I was thinking, right, if you could only eat one type of cake for the rest of your life, what
How is this going to help my invention?
Research, yes, into sunshine. Yeah, because we were talking to the internet, actually, right, and he was saying that this bright white sunlight is actually made up of lots of different colours.
Oh.
Yeah? And when it hits things, some of the colours are absorbed and some of them bounce back. You got those?
Yeah.
Yeah. So you know our shiny ball?
Yeah.
Yeah. That was bouncing back green light, so it looked green. Now you want your ball to bounce back white light, don't you?
Yeah.
So you get all those tiny little white lights dancing around the room. So what we need to do is wrap your ball in something that doesn't absorb any light at all. So if we shine white light at it, we get white light back.
And I'm awesome.
Yeah, it does make sense, doesn't it? So what we've got to do is find something that's shinier than our van, but not a colour.
A mirror.
Sorry, we're thinking.
A mirror.
Isn't it? It's okay. Shiny in our van, but not a colour.
Ed, a mirror.
So, Molly, just play with these bananas or something, will you? Oh, I've got it!
Oh, what?
No, it's gone again.
A mirror.
Oh, no, it's back!
Huh?
A mirror!
Oh, day!
Yeah, I'm so clever sometimes, aren't I?
Oh, day. Ed, I got a mirror at the bottom.
We've got one in the back of the van.
Day.
Oh, great, good.
Oh, Ed, it talks, yes.
And it talks?
Mm-hmm.
Of course it does. Yeah. It's best to humour him in these situations. Yeah. Let's go and find your talking mirror, mate. Oh, fair enough. There is a mirror in here.
Toldy. I'm gonna head. I'm gonna wake him off.
Got to wake it up. Right, yeah. Mirror, woo, wake up. Mirror, mirror on the wall. Who is the fairest of them all?
Tennis umpires, of course. They're pretty fair, yeah. Then there's judges, Simon Cow. Oh, yeah, he's very honest. Sometimes a bit too honest, if you ask me. Fairest of them all, though. Tricky question.
Oh, that wasn't actually what I wanted to ask you, Mirror.
Then you should be very careful about asking unimportant questions. You only get to ask me 3 questions, and you've already asked one, so you've only got 2 left.
Really?
Yes! Now you've only got 1 left.
Eh!
Can we get on with this, please? I've got a busy afternoon ahead of me.
No, you haven't. You just sit in the back of our van.
Yeah, well, I've got some thinking to do. Reflecting, so to speak.
Ah, right. Oh, no, that's what I need to talk to you about, actually. Reflecting light. Because we're trying to build this thing called a rainbow go-go, and it needs to reflect light. Do you know much about mirrors, Mirror?
Yes! Sorry, that was your final question. Goodbye.
No, wait.
What?
Oh, come on, we're desperate.
OK, look. There's this girl called Danielle Darwin. She works on the makeup counter down at the local department store. She's surrounded by mirrors all day long. Anyway, she might be able to help you.
Oh, brilliant. I'll pop you back now.
Oh, thanks. Oh, and by the way, Ed, could you bring me a slice of cake this afternoon?
Mirrors don't eat cake.
They don't speak either, yet here we are.
Yeah, fair enough, I suppose. I'll see what I can do.
Thanks.
Right, let's drive down the department store. What? Oh. Yeah, I forgot our van was broken. Molly, come here. I don't suppose your dad would let us borrow his van, would he?
I don't think so, but I might have something else.
This is embarrassing. Hello, Danielle.
Oh, hello.
Oh, she's truly attractive.
Who's strangely attractive?
Oh, bless. What can I help you with, babes?
Well, we need to find out about mirrors and stuff for this disco ball we're trying to make, and we thought since you work with mirrors all the time, you might know a bit about them.
Oh, I do, as it happens. Partly from working here, and partly from my PhD in light and reflective technologies from King's College, Oxford.
Oh, right. So, how do mirrors work, then?
Well, all sources of light produce rays, and those rays bounce off things like handbags and footballers and puppies.
Yeah, we learnt all about light from the internet, actually.
Well, with most objects, like handbags and...
Footballers and puppies, yeah.
Well, when the light hits them, it gets changed. And when it bounces into our eyes, we see those changes as shape and texture.
And colour. Yeah, we learnt about that as well.
But there's some objects, like mirrors, that are so good at bouncing the light back that it hardly changes at all.
This is perfect.
Who's perfect?
And if the light hits the mirror, right, so that's the mirror. If the light hits the mirror at this angle, yeah, then it bounces off at the same angle in a different direction. And if you move the mirror, the angle changes.
So what's the best reflective thing to wrap around something ball-shaped?
Oh, I don't know, I never asked.
Oh, well, thanks for your help. Come on. Right, Molly, you're probably wondering why I brought you here.
Yeah.
Well, Danielle's got us up to speed with reflections and stuff. So, the big question is...
Are we going to get this van fixed?
Well, are we going to get our van fixed is a big question, yes. But the bigger question is...
Where is your costume?
Where is your elf costume?
Dee.
Yes, where has that gone? Oh, I really have no idea.
No, no. The big question is, what's the best way to reflect light off a ball? Are you ready?
Yeah.
Now, we've got this spinny stick thing here. We're going to put the ball on there. These lights here that will hopefully get the light reflecting off the balls really well. Outro's in charge of turning off the main lights. What are we testing? Water is reflective. So I thought maybe a ball soaked in water might be a way to go. Also, we've got a Christmas bauble. That's kind of shiny. Metal was reflective. I used this to wrap my sandwiches earlier. I haven't bothered cleaning it. I'm sure it'll be fine. And then this weird thing here that we knocked up.
It might work.
Yeah, it's a couple of mirrors strapped to the side of a ball. I'm not sure about it. Shall we begin?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, lovely.
Outro, turn off the lights.
All right.
Get really close, lovely! What do you think of that?
Well, it didn't reflect.
Light off! Let's give this a bit of a clean, actually. Hang on. Can't have a wet camera. Right. Which one next?
That one with the ham and cheese in it.
Good, good.
Stuff back in there. Oh dear, I was going everywhere already. Right.
Light off!
Let's start spinning. Keep an eye on the lights. Wasn't that impressive, was it?
No.
Keep trashing this camera, though. Probably don't need that. What do you want to go for next?
The bauble, I think. It looks quite shiny.
It does look quite shiny, doesn't it? Here we go! What do you think of that?
It didn't do as well as I thought it would.
No, it just kind of glowed, didn't it?
Yeah.
You didn't get those little lights you're after. Do you want to stick that on, then? OK, lights off, please, Outro! OK. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, go! Oh, it's reflecting off your face. Oh, and smashing into the camera as well. This poor camera. What did you think of that?
Brilliant. I think it was the best.
Yeah, it was, wasn't it? No, that was really good. I think what we need to do is build a ball 60 feet high with about 200 different mirrors like that all around it, and then we'll have exactly what we need.
We could just keep the ball the same size with lots of little mirrors.
Yeah, yeah, or we could do that as well, if you want. I'm starting to think this carrot cake's all right, actually.
Huh?
And it's really made out of carrots.
Yep.
If you ask me, the people who are in charge of naming things are getting pretty lazy.
Me.
Next they're going to be telling us that rainbows are made out of rain.
I live.
Although we better find out what they are made out of, otherwise we're not going to get paid.
The boss band are put on Gorna.
Yes, we'll be able to find the pot of gold and fix our van.
That reminds me. Hmm? I've got the price of the exhaust for your van.
Oh, great. Lovely. Thank you.
Oh, and some cheese.
No, it isn't cheap. No.
Oh.
A big cheese is going to be taking this out of our wages for 5 years.
Oh, no.
9 years.
Oh, no. Not nearly out of the ones in me. Oh.
It's all right, it's all right, it's all right. There must be somebody around here who knows how rainbows are made. Now it's raining.
There's a former desk on the hill.
Yeah, I know there's a strange woman trying to talk to us. Just avoid eye contact.
Huh?
I hear you're looking for weather information.
Huh? Yeah, we were, but we're all right now, thanks.
Well, maybe I can be of assistance.
Oh, I recognise you. You're that weather girl off the telly.
I'm in disguise.
Oh, why?
Them. They're everywhere, and they don't want the public knowing too much information.
What, about weather information?
Exactly. Take rainbows, for example.
Oh, we need to know about those.
Rainbows are made of light. In this case, sunlight. Light slows down when it hits a raindrop.
And that's how rainbows are made?
Yes. Something top secret happens when light hits a raindrop.
What? What?
It's called refraction.
Oh, wow. What's refraction?
Refraction happens when light slows down, hits a raindrop, and allows us to see the separate colours that make up a light beam. Imagine the colours in a beam of light as a line of agents, running at the same speed in a line. When we view them front on, we see them in a line. But when we view them side on, we only see one agent. But what would happen if they hit a patch of mud?
The government will catch them.
Yeah, the government will catch them.
No, they each slow down when they get to the mud.
Oh.
If the mud was at an angle, like the edge of a raindrop, then one agent would come out of the mud first, he'd be back on the grass, running fast, getting ahead of the other agents, and we would see him clearly. Then the next one would come out and run off, then the next one, and so on. As the line isn't straight anymore, we can see each separate agent. This is what happens when white light passes through a raindrop. Rather than seeing the big group, which is white light, we see each individual colour that makes up a rainbow.
Ah, that's fantastic. So water breaks the sunlight up into its separate colours.
Shh.
Oh, sorry.
That's right, and we call that refraction. Each raindrop is only creating a tiny piece of the rainbow, and the colours are being refracted all over the place. So you need hundreds and thousands of raindrops to shine at the same time if you want to see a rainbow.
That's great. Thank you very much.
That's right. And tell no one you've seen me.
OK, yeah, we haven't seen you.
Just this.
Yeah, I know. She was weird, wasn't she? Seems much more normal on the telly. Anyway, we know about rainbows now. All we need is a big light and some water. Simple. Oi! Look, I told you, you can't be an elf again.
Meh.
That elf costume went missing, mysteriously.
Hi, guys. I've got some non-carrot-based cake here.
Cuckers!
Oh, lovely. Yeah, we'll have that in a bit, OK? We've got some work to do first. Cos, Moles, we're about to do the final test on your weather machine. Yeah, have a look at this. We've got indoor sunlight shining on this, your disco ball.
Brilliant.
Also, you're going to love this bit. Yeah! Donut drawer.
Fantastic.
Yeah, you peckish?
Yeah.
Right, well, yeah. That's for later, so you can't have any now. Also, we've got your music maker. So what do you think?
It's not bad.
Yeah, you're right, it is brilliant. We've still got the final test, and that is on this, the rainbow maker.
It looks just like a bunch of hoses.
Yes, it might look like that to you, yeah? But Oucher and I are trained professionals. We know what we're doing.
Safety alert! Safety alert! Safety alert!
Of course, messing around with hoses full of water and electrical lights is very dangerous, so don't try it at home. It'd be stupid! OK, Ouchmeister, are you ready?
Nos!
Molly, you ready?
Yep.
OK. One rainbow coming up. Oh. Can you see the rainbow?
No!
Can you see it?
Oh.
I can't see it! Turn it off! Molly! I can't see it! I have water in my eyes!
It's stuck!
My television eyes!
Did you see the rainbow?
No, I didn't, no. Oh, no, you poor thing! Oh, you poor thing! Are you right? Oh, no, it's ruined! Oh, you poor little cake!
What? Halibar's mute!
Oh, let's get you dried off.
Meh.
Well, I'm not going to lie to you, Molly. That didn't go exactly as planned.
Mm-mm.
We all got wet, and that poor little cake died in vain.
It didn't really make a rainbow either.
Yeah, all right, don't rub it in.
And over in the Midlands, there'll be rain hanging about for the next 24 hours.
Hang on a minute, that's it!
Why, the
Midlands? No, not the Midlands. No. What does she say in the park?
So you need hundreds and thousands of raindrops to shine at the same time if you want to see a big rainbow.
We haven't got enough raindrops.
Oh.
We need more to cover a wider area. Then we'll get our rainbow.
Let's make it a spray.
Yeah, that's a brilliant idea.
I don't think I want them to.
Oh, no, you definitely won't get wet this time.
No.
Come on, let's get building.
This week was frankly a pretty tough call.
Oh, dear.
A weather machine with a built-in disco ball. Design was called the Rainbow Go-Go. I have to admit, I thought it was a no-no. The internet told us about color and light. I was convinced we'd get our disco ball right. We got a green beach ball that was nice and bright. To say it was pathetic would be being polite. That's what we need.
Yeah.
Marley then suggested a mirror, and me and Oucho agreed. Got a magic mirror from the back of the van. It sent us to a woman who looked a bit like a man. She said light needs something shiny to reflect it. We tested different shiny things so we could perfect it. For our next question, asked her weather girl. She told us how rainbows are made, we gave it a whirl. Our rain was too heavy, but we got the gist. All we need now is a fine water of mist for a fraction. That's what we need. Yeah, yeah. And if we get this final test right, I'm pretty sure we'll succeed.
Well, I've got to say, Molly, that wasn't the easiest invention we've ever made, but then it was a pretty tall order.
They were a fluffy nightmare.
I wouldn't go as far as say it was a living nightmare. Anyway, should we show everybody at home?
Yep.
Molly asked us to make her a weather-making disco machine, the Rainbow A-Go-Go. It had to provide food, music, and rainbows. And here it is! No, not really. Not that useless, are we? No, here it is! Look at that, look at that, a real-life rainbow! Although it's not much of a party without your friends, is it? Molly's friends!
Well, it's one for the money, two for the show, three to get ready, now go, cat, go, but don't you step on my blue suede shoe. Well, you can do anything but take me over my blue suede shoes. Let's go, cat!
How's it going, Molly?
Fantastic.
Yeah, what's been your favourite bit so far?
The rainbow went really good.
Yeah, it did, didn't it?
The put a corner! Put a corner!
Oh, he wants to find a pot of gold at the end of the rainbow so he can buy an exhaust for the van. See? I told you there was no such thing as the end of the rainbow. It's a myth. It's a fairy tale. It's a load of made-up old bobbins like the Loch Ness Monster or Sam and Mark's recording contract.
I'm the Buster Bundy.
Yeah, I don't think we'll ever be able to afford to fix our van. We may have made Molly's dreams come true, but ours have been smashed to a million pieces.
D.
Ow!
What?
As if that wasn't bad enough, I just banged my shin on this.
What?
Exhaust for a 1977 camper van. Ow! And this box that says free camper van parts, please take. Come on, mate. Looks like we're walking from now on.